would everyone please stand to greet our bride? Today supports our bride, Juliana, as she joins her heart and life to our groom, Matthew.
We do.
Thank you, everyone. Please be seated. Good early evening, friends and family. A wedding is such a wonderful occasion filled with hopes, dreams, tears of love, and excitement. We are here today to celebrate the love that Juliana and Matthew have for each other and to rejoice and witness their decision to journey forward in their lives together. A marriage is not merely created by a law or a ceremony. Rather, it occurs in the hearts of the individuals. It grows out of loving, caring, and sharing ourselves with another. Juliana and Matthew have pledged to continue this amazing bond, which does not begin here today, but which began when they first recognized a special spark in one another, fueled by a shared belief that when we love, we always strive to become better than we are. Juliana and Matthew are truly better together and will continue to grow and develop with the nurturing support of each other. With love in our hearts, we take a moment to remember family members who are no longer with us today but would be rejoicing with us all if they were. All those gone, loved but not forgotten, can be felt here today as their love and spirits are watching over Juliana and Matthew and their families during this wonderful time of celebration. And speaking of family, Juliana and Matthew are pleased to have their parents close to them for the ceremony. Parents, Farida, Bill, Ina, and Bob, look at your beautiful children standing before you today as bride and groom, and very soon to be husband and wife. They have tremendous respect for the values you have instilled in their lives. And from you, they have learned to have a solid foundation to be responsible, compassionate, and strong, as well as dedicated to their family and friends. Thank you, dear parents. The philosopher Socrates tells us, there is no possession more valuable than a good and faithful friend. Juliana and Matt would like to acknowledge and thank their family, friends, and wedding party. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, gentlemen. for all their help with the pre-wedding celebrations and today's festivities. They also want to thank those who have traveled a far distance to be witness to their ceremony. All of you here have given them much happiness, love, warmth, and guidance through the various stages of their lives. Because you are the ones who have supported and known them so well, it is only fitting that you are the ones to share in this once-in-a-lifetime moment. And so it is that Juliana and Matt present themselves to be married today, surrounded by the people they love the most. In honor of Juliana's mother's family background, I'd like to share this Baha'i wedding reading. Baha'i marriage is union and cordial affection between two parties. They must, however, exercise the utmost care and become acquainted with each other's character. This eternal bond should be made secure by a firm covenant, and the intention should be to foster harmony, fellowship, unity, and to attain everlasting life. And in that spirit, I'd like to share with you some of the wonderful and beautiful things I learned about Juliana and Matt's love. Our honored couple met back at Temple University in 2012 during their spring semester of their freshman year. Juliana and Matt had some mutual friends, so they'd always end up at the same event. Now, our bride here remembers seeing Matt at a party and thought he was this really cute but shy guy who she wanted to get to know more. Matt recalls how Juliana made the first move, as he was very shy in his early days of college. One night, a group of friends went out to McDonald's, and at that time, Juliana and Matt were not quite dating. They were talking, but not dating. But they sat next to each other. And Juliana, very nonchalantly, started to pick at Matt's fries. And the rest was history. Matt recalls her looks, intelligence, and confidence won him over that day, and it continues to win him over every single day. During their 10 years together, Juliana and Matt, along with their relationship, grew and matured. They endured long-distance dating for 2 years, and when Juliana got a job offer in New York City, Matt didn't hesitate to move to Jersey City with her, and they happily made it through COVID living in New Jersey. In their years together, they have added a number of stamps to their passports with their travel adventures. They love the Caribbean and have island hopped to many of the beautiful beaches with dreamy blue waters. They took an amazing trip to Amsterdam and Brussels and have plans to acquire more stamps and hopefully run out of passport pages with their future European vacations. Juliana and Matt have also been through a number of challenging life events that have taken place in the last decade. But it only made their relationship deeper and stronger since they had each other to lean on and to depend on. Now Matt was getting ready to pop the all-important question. Living in a tiny one-bedroom apartment during COVID with nowhere to go and nothing to do showed Matt if he could last through the world turned sideways and become even closer. It was obvious that he wanted Juliana to be his forever. And on January 30th, 2021, Matt decided to ask Juliana during the pandemic. So it was impossible to get her dressed up without tipping off the surprise. Now we were all living in our pajamas back then. He took her to the waterfront in Jersey City, nervous he might drop the ring into the river. Juliana was completely oblivious until Matt bent down on one knee and proposed marriage. And here we are today. Juliana and Matt have brought us all together to illustrate their love and commitment through the wonder of their marriage ceremony. When I asked what do you love about one another and why they've chosen to take on this crazy life journey together, Juliana shared, "I love how Matt is a great friend and is always willing to do whatever it takes to help someone in need. Plus, he is always there for his parents, siblings, and niece. I admire how he can be strong without being harsh, and his creative mind is always thinking of new inventions. I know that I have a partner for life in Matt. He is my biggest supporter, confidant, the person I can't go a day without talking to. We are the perfect match and are truly partners in everything we do. I can't imagine life without him. We have made a conscious decision to choose each other and to be there for one another, no matter what." And Matt related, "Besides her outer beauty, I love how Juliana understands and gets me on all levels. In college, she helped me break out of my shell and move forward, but mostly her intelligence never ceases to amaze me. I could feel her love and support, and there's never been a time where I felt she doesn't champion me or my decisions. After 10 years of dating and living together for almost 6 years, there is still never a moment in life that I don't want to spend it without her. Every event or activity is better with her, even when we're just sitting on the couch, on our own phones, not talking for hours. It's always better to know she's right by my side." Juliana and Matt, today you carry forward with you all the good times that you have shared and make a commitment to share in many more good times to come. As husband and wife, you will appreciate each other. You will laugh a lot. You will take on new challenges together, and you will grow older and wiser together. It's a great story with many chapters, and the ending is not in sight. Throughout history, in nearly all cultures and traditions, the sharing of a cup of wine has been a symbol of joy, of the richness of life and the sweetness of love. It is appropriate, therefore, that on this happy occasion, you toast life with this ancient symbol. Wine, like a good relationship, is, after all, the result of years of hard work, tender care, a thoughtful mix of ingredients, patience, and a labor of love. The years of our lives are a cup of wine poured out for us to drink. Juliana and Matt, as you share this wine now, you promise to share all that the future may bring. All the sweetness the fruits of life may hold for you should be sweeter because you drink it together. And whatever drops of bitterness it may contain should be lessened because they are shared. And I'm sure you'll all agree, Juliana and Matt are the perfect vintage. Hold it up. For this ritual, our happy couple is using a kiddush cup Matt's parents brought back from their trip to Israel. I will now recite the Hebrew blessing over the wine and read the English translation. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pori hagafen. Blessed art thou, Lord our God, King of the universe, creator of the fruit of the vine. And I ask everyone here to take a moment to visualize a wondrous future for our bride and groom as they toast to their love. And now, please toast the love and fond memories you've shared in the past, to your love in the present on this your glorious wedding day, and toast to your growing love with each anniversary and forevermore. before you, Juliana, and you, Matthew, are joined together in marriage in my presence and in the presence of your family and friends, please remember this. The hands and heart which you each offer to the other is an extension of yourselves. Just as the warmth and love which you express to each other. Cherish the touch, for you are touching and joining with another life. Be sensitive to its pulse and try to understand and respect its flow and rhythm just as you do your own. Matthew, the woman whose hand you're holding and whose eyes you're looking into loves you very, very much. And so I ask you, Matthew, will you take Juliana to be your wife, your lifelong partner? Will you forever love her, respect her, and believe in her? To share your life openly with her, to speak truthfully and lovingly to her, to accept her fully as she is and delight in who she is becoming, to respect her uniqueness, encourage her fulfillment, and compassionately support her through all the changes of your years together?
I do.
And Juliana, the man whose eyes you're looking into and whose hands you're holding, loves and adores you very, very much. And so I ask you, will you take Matthew to be your husband, your lifelong partner? Will you forever love him, respect him, and believe in him? To share your life openly with him, to speak truthfully and lovingly to him, to accept him fully as he is, delight in who he is becoming, to respect his uniqueness, encourage his fulfillment, and compassionately support him through all the changes of your years together?
I do.
Juliana and Matthew, the symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Now you shall say a few words that will take you across a threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
I, Matthew, take you, Juliana, to be my wife. I promise to love, honor, and adore you. I promise to laugh with you in the good times and support you through the bad. I promise to love you forever and always.
I, Juliana, take you, Matthew, to be my husband, my friend, my love, and my lifelong companion, to share my life with yours, to build our dreams together, to support you through times of trouble, and to rejoice with you in times of happiness. To help you become the person that you aspire to be, I give you my hand, my heart, and my love from this day forward for as long as we both shall live.
We usually talk about wedding bands being a perfect circle with no beginning and no end. But we all know that these rings do have a beginning. Rock is dug up from the earth. Metal is liquefied in a furnace, then molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. Something beautiful is made from something raw. And love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings and is forged over time. It's the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. Juliana and Matthew, these rings are a token of that love which you have forged and that will last forever. And may your rings be blessed as a sign of your great love, commitment, and faithfulness. Adam, would you do the honors and please give Juliana's ring to Matthew? Take Annie's hand. Matthew, please repeat after me as you place this ring on Juliana's finger. Juliana, accept this ring as a symbol of my love.
Juliana, accept this ring as a symbol of my love.
And a sign that I take you as my wife.
And a sign that I take you as my wife.
To love, cherish, and grow with.
To love, cherish, and grow with.
Through all of our days.
Through all of our days.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
Adam, would you do the honors again and hand Matt's ring to Juliana?
Take your honey's hand.
Juliana, please repeat after me as you place this ring on Matthew's finger. Matthew, accept this ring as a symbol of my love.
Matthew, accept this ring as a symbol of my love.
And a sign that I take you as my husband.
And a sign that I take you as my husband.
To love, cherish, and grow with.
To love, cherish, and grow with.
Through all of our days.
Through all of our days.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
Juliana and Matthew, you have come before us and pledged your love and hearts to one another. May you respect each other's individual personality and philosophy and give each other room to grow. May your sense of humor and playful spirit continue to enliven your relationship. May you be friends, lovers, and partners, meeting the joys and cares of life as one. May your lips stay forever sweet, and may you always be happy in one another's arms. And let your love be stronger than your anger, and look for the best in your beloved rather than the worst. Learn the wisdom of compromise, for it is better to bend than to break. And remember, in addition to saying the words, I love you, to speak through your actions of your love for one another daily. And long, long years from now, may you look at one another with a twinkle in your eye and be able to say, because of you, I have lived the life I've always wanted to live. Because of you, I have become the person I always longed to be. May your home be blessed and filled with the sound of laughter and the feeling of warmth that comes from a life of love, joy, harmony, and good health. And since you are both joyfully committed to this union, let me formally declare that I, April Beer, interfaith minister, and duly authorized to solemnize your marriage according to the laws of the state of New Jersey. But before Juliana and Matt can seal the deal, Matt must break the glass. The ritual of breaking the glass symbolizes many things. For today's ceremony, it signifies the wishing of good luck to our newly married couple and is a sign of good fortune and tells us that our joy and the couple's love in this union are so great that no vessel can contain it. And in the Italian tradition, the number of shards of glass also indicate the many happy years Juliana and Matt will spend together. And as Matt breaks the glass, I invite you all to join in wishing them good luck by shouting out Mazel Tov or congratulations. Matt and Juliana, may you be in love for life and in front of your family and friends. It was absolute delight. I'm honored to declare you husband and wife. Matt, you may kiss your bride and seal that deal. Hey.